Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the disclaimer. That's right, the disclaimer. This American apple pie institution known as parental discretion will cleanse any sense of innuendo or sarcasm from the lyrics, which might actually make you think, and will also insult your intelligence at the same time. So protect your family. This album contains explicit depictions of things which are real. These real things are commonly known as life. So if it sounds sarcastic, don't take it seriously. If it sounds dangerous, do not try this at home or at all. And if it offends you, just don't listen to it.
People in jail in America now than ever before.
In the United States, it's one of the fastest growing industries.
Some major investment companies at one time described private prisons as one of the best investments you could make.
So you can make more money building prisons than any other type of investment.
They're extraordinarily expensive to build. They're even far more expensive to operate and maintain.
Now in the United States of America, the biggest growth industry is the privatized prison complex.
Japan, for instance, incarcerates at 38 people per 100,000 population. The United States incarcerates at a rate of 726 people per 100,000 population. In a 20-year period, the prison population in the United States quadrupled.
We have just shy of 5% of the world's population and almost 25% of its prisoners.
Even South Africa, at its worst, didn't have as many prisoners per capita as America has now.
Texas just built 77 prisons in about the last 20 years.
We find state treasuries on the verge of bankruptcy as a result of prison construction.
Some think there won't be room for them in jail. We'll make room. We're almost doubling prison space. Some think there aren't enough prosecutors. We'll hire them, with the largest increase in federal prosecutors in history.
I couldn't comprehend. Wrote a goodbye letter to my family and hung myself.
When it comes to kids and punishment, the question needs to be answered. Do kids, no matter what the crime, belong in adult prison?
It's a complicated issue just because of the fact that they are still juveniles, so they're still young in mind and body and spirit and everything. Yet they have committed some pretty serious crimes against society. The natural reaction, particularly for a kid who's going into an environment like that, they learn survival skills. And it's not a positive learning environment either.
And I'm 15 years old. It's overwhelming just to know that there's people in here that can be like my grandpa. So it's really quite odd. Because everybody calls me youngin, and I'm always treated like, well, I'm like a little kid. On the news, they made it sound like I was just horrible, you know, like cold-blooded. My crime might seem like that, but like I'm not the person that they may think I am from reading something.
Introduced such innovations as a tent city jail and no television for prisoners, sees chain gangs as a valuable deterrent.
I put the chain gang right smack in downtown. I want everybody to see the chain gang because I want the mother to drive by. I want them to say to the daughter, see, honey, you do something wrong, you're going to be working that chain gang. And the mothers on that chain gang, you know what they say? Yes, thank you for giving me that opportunity, because we may save our daughter one day.
Maricopa County prisoners work 6 days a week performing community services. Sheriff Arpaio estimates that work done by his chain gangs has saved the county over $500,000 in the first 3 years of the program.
But so what? In fact, I hope that they look at the word chain gang as very, very bad, awful, not brutal, not inhumane, maybe embarrassing. Okay. Hey, so if you don't want to be embarrassed, don't commit a crime and don't go to jail and be convicted.
Rather than trying to construct in some abstract way a perfect model, it would be worth comparing where we seem to be today with the moment of the birth of the prison in the late 18th century. Because one of the things that is clear is that they thought about punishment in terms not only of what they thought of as justice in the law, but in terms of what they believed a just society should be. Today, those questions are too often separated. And the question of justice in a broader sense gets subordinated to the question of justice in the narrow sense.